Born in Paarl in 1947, Slobod Stephen Biza would later lecture at the University of Cape Town in the Department of African Languages. This after completing a BA degree at the University of Fort Hare and teaching at Idiom Kize High School in Guguletu.
My father, happens to be my father, he set a good example. And every year we revive his works. As he was an activist, he stood for people during the apartheid, but he used education more to empower black people. And not only that, but he was a unifier. As we saw today, one of his students who's a professor today in the local languages, you know. So he was trying also to unite the races during the time of racism. So he was a unifier, he was an activist, and we are doing this so that we can teach our youth and we can mold new leaders.
Khadebe says African restoration is the responsibility of every person and is sorely needed in every sector of society.
When we understand our spirituality, we will begin to understand who we are and our roots, where we come from. And once you understand who you are, where you come from, that's the only way you start understanding where you are going to. And so you can see as a nation, we are completely lost, especially the African part, the Africans. We are completely lost. But if we start following our own way and practice our own spirituality, that will give us an identity and a direction of where we should go.
A moderated panel discussion aimed at challenging the notion that Africa was a dark continent without spirituality or culture prior to colonization, and that Africans are lagging in innovation and progress across spheres of business, agriculture and education.
When we were liberated, then it was said that all cultures are equal, all languages are equal. Now what we want to do today is that we can say, yes, they are equal, but there are those who are more equal than others. And ours was taken forcefully from the center to the margin. So before we're talking about equality, have we made means to remove or to take our African culture and African languages from the margin back to the center? So that is why the conference today is talking about a journey towards the restoration of African culture and African languages. Well, these two, they go together. It's not that they are separate, because language also shows the culture of the people.
A former Xhosa student of Mbiza says he was a passionate and principled educator.
He was a person with immense gifts of being able to reach out to people who knew nothing. Because often that's a frustration, that people don't know anything. And that he reached out to us, you know, white people, age 25 as I was at the time, not having grown up in the Eastern Cape, being completely blank and saying, you can do it. So I think he was inspirational in saying to anyone, you can do it. And I think, like with the Khadebe Foundation, they're saying, you can do it. You can make businesses, you can do things. So that incredible inspiration to make you love the language and to make you believe in yourself.
Mbiza was also described as a person who was passionate about education and even taught students Xhosa extramurally. Vanessa Puna, SABC News, Cape Town.